What you're going to hear about today, made possible only through years of research, invention, and innovation, and distinct soundtrack.
One thing that I think separates the Black Dynamite music material is that the stuff started at the source.
This puts the music into a dimension that is unique.
Straight to tape.
A really old microphone.
Into a tube EQ, into a tube compressor, back onto a two-track.
And this is where a lot of the soul of it comes from.
It's best described as presence, a feeling of life and nearness in the music.
Final product just has a certain kind of depth to it that you can't get with a modern mic into a little Pro Tools rig.
Are you with me?
Yeah, I can dig it. I want to tell you a story about a friend I've had. He's a mean mother and he's super bad. So grab onto your seats and hang on tight while I tell you a story about Black Dynamite.
Funk music defines black quotation.
And our soundtrack was an homage to a musical era.
And that's the feel, that's the soul of the movie.
These are things that are important culturally.
All these things gave such a texture to the genre that when the music evolved into disco, it pretty much killed the genre of film.
He's doing like that way! He's feeling like the feet.
You know, I've mastered a lot of stuff from the 70s as well as the soundtrack for the Black Dynamite stuff, and when I initially got the mixes for Black Dynamite, it was almost kind of eerie how close the stuff was.
It actually sounds like your most favorite find or dig, the most obscure soundtrack. You just took it home and it was just so just dope.
I could really imagine a Mad Lib or, you know, a hip-hop producer digging through these recordings and going, oh, there's the break.
And this is something that has been lost generally in music.
It's not going to surprise me when these recordings end up in some hip-hop songs in the future.
Would you like to hear a sample?
I'm with you.
All right. Now.
Shots will blind your sight. I'm that kind in life, in the streets otherwise known as Black Dynamite. Tick, 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 boom, when I come through the room. Dirty Harry 44 mag in my hand, come feel it soon.
You have just seen and heard a little of the film and record. The quality of the records and film speaks for itself.
The first time I heard this music, Adrian elicited a response of something that seems so spontaneous, but yet it's not spontaneous because it was composed.
He would start with an MPC.
And I would set a metronome and I would go one.
And two, and one, and two.
And then I'd print this on about 4 minutes of tape. And I would play all my instruments over this metronome.
I hear a flute part, and I'm like, who the hell's playing flute? And it's all that to me. And I'm like, how the hell did you learn how to play flute? And it's, oh, well, you know, I wrote the part, and then I went and I bought a flute. And then I just kept doing it and doing it and doing it until I got it right. And then it was this maddening pace of trying to get the part right, not quite getting it the first time, running over, hit stop, rewind, play record, run back, and then try to record it again, back and forth and back and forth until it was right.
Wax Poetics Records was conceived to reissue our favorite records that we thought were going unrecognized. We weren't necessarily thinking about putting out new acts, but it was definitely something that we, you know, had considered when I did finally get a chance to hear the Black Dynamite score. It pretty much confirmed what we finally found, a Wax Poetics sound.
You are going on a ride. A ride on the diamond tip as it plunges down through a canyon of sound where music is made. Two totally different soundtracks coming from one groove. It's the most tremendous new musical experience you can have. And now it's available for everyone.
Hear how you can buy it.
Somebody broke into Jimmy's bag. Are they still there? Something could be anywhere.